on any other occasion, and there have been several. When a person not paying attention has bumped me while driving, as long as there is no damage to my car, I've let it go. I don't call anyone. I don't go fishing for compensation. I take a pic of the plate and insurance, then get back on the road. This time, an older woman tried to turn right from the left-hand lane of an intersection. I honked when I knew she was about to hit me, then she tapped my rear driver tire well with the front pack's quarter panel of her brand new car. We pull over and immediately shh the beach. Cranky butt old lady slamming doors and hollering like it's all my fault. I take a photo of her plate, then a photo of the intersection. I ask for a photo of her insurance and offer her mine. She gives me a receipt from where she just got the insurance from, dated an hour ago. She snatched it back from my hand because I'm taking enough pictures. I decide that's all I need and leave and go home. I also decided this time to call her insurance and make a claim. Not so much for damage, there wasn't any to my car, but hers was dented and scuffed. Hell, I know I'm not getting anything out of this, except sweet satisfaction that I devalued her car and raised her insurance rates. I lived in a quad my first semester at uni. I was a transfer student, while my three roommates were all freshmen. I never really talked to any of them because I have really bad anxiety. We each had our own bedroom, with two bathrooms to split between us, as well as a common lounge space and kitchenette. Because of my anxiety, I didn't always feel comfortable going to the dining hall. It wasn't a big deal though, cause I was able to have my own food stocked up. I noticed that my milk carton kept being moved around the fridge. In of itself, it wasn't a big deal. The issue was that whoever was moving my milk was using it without my permission. I'm a non-confrontational person. I started clearly marking the milk carton with lines each time I had any milk as a passive way to say I know someone's using my milk and I'm keeping track now, so back off. No success, so I decided to step up my game. I was 99% sure I knew which roommate was drinking my milk, and she wasn't the one I was stuck sharing a bathroom with. So when the milk ran out, I went to the store to buy a new carton and the cheapest powder laxative I could find. If no one was going to acknowledge that they were stealing my milk, I wasn't going to either. It's my milk, so why should I have to tell anyone that I put a whole bottle of laxative powder in it? After that, I never had to draw lines on my milk carton or worry about anyone taking my food again. Edit: to clarify why I went to such lengths, this roommate was known to take things from other roommates' rooms if the doors weren't locked, even after the other girls asked her to stop. She came into my room one time when my door was unlocked and closed while I was taking a nap, and I caught her in the act of trying to take a handful of my tampons. The one time I did confront her about something, using my dishes and refusing to clean them, she literally started to scream at me until we got a noise complaint. Point being, this girl couldn't be reasoned with, and it felt like this was the only way to get my point across. Another edit: after seeing a similar theme in the comments, I want to clarify that I'm not trying to use my anxiety as justification for my actions or say that I'm innocent in this whole situation. I only mentioned my anxiety to try to better put things into perspective. Looking back, I can assure you that I'm aware that what I did was extreme, and I won't repeat it again if given the chance. Since then, I've been diagnosed with more mental health conditions that I can clearly see influenced my thought process at the time. Again, I'm not using my mental health as an excuse for my actions. I understand how it might seem that way and apologize for any misunderstanding, but to try and give a fuller picture of the situation from my perspective. I'd consider my roommates R and B good friends, and we get on well most of the time. We do have our normal problems though, and this is a story of the most recent one. B and I are currently preparing for exams, as hers later in January. So it's pretty quiet in our flat right now. B and I go to bed early, wake up early to study. R is enjoying her free time, goes to bed at 1 in the morning, and gets up at 9-ish, sometimes later. That's fine with me, I'm just envious of her free time. Unfortunately, she kept waking me up by turning the lights on or generally being noisy. No big deal. I tell her politely to keep it down, but it doesn't stop, and after a couple of days of being woken up past midnight, I'm pissed. Annoyed and tired as I was, I text her a link to a website with the time that is customarily considered nighttime in our country. They are from 10 p.m. to 6 a.m. Widely common and federal lawsuits are sometimes based on them. I text her to again please be considerate of us and that I'll be happy to keep it down when it's her time for exams. I was passive aggressive, I know. But I thought it was really inconsiderate and I had had enough. This is where she tried to be petty. Each night, until 10, she listens to music or watches movies without headphones, is loud in the kitchen, or invites friends over. This is unusual, and I realize what she's trying to do. However, I doesn't realize that B and I don't go to bed until 11, so it doesn't bother us at all. But I do get up at 6:30, and if she's being petty, so will I. I wait until B is awake, because I'm not trying to annoy slash her slash. Then, I unload the dishwasher, forgetting to close the kitchen door. I brush my teeth with my electric toothbrush, again forgetting to close doors. I might not have closed the front door as gently as I usually would. I might have woken A up at 8ish by doing all of these things. But it's past 6, so A stops being petty at night after that. I'm not woken up again past midnight. We also talked about it, apologized, and it's all good now. But how she didn't see the flaw in her plan, I really don't know. I went to Popis 2 weeks ago and thought this experience would fit here. It was around 7 p.m. and was wanting some chicken. In my area they only sell those infamous chicken sandwiches from like 11 a.m. till 6 p.m. So I figured it wouldn't be too crazy. I got in line and ordered strips and a drink for myself and same for my wife who was at home. I also ordered side of jalapenos and a side of fries and a biscuit for my wife. When I got to the window they did that thing where they tell you your total and hold your soda like a hostage till you hand them payment. I hate when they do that, but I get it because someone ruined it for everyone else. I paid for my food and drink and the guy hands me my drink and then all my food in one bag. I started looking through my bag to confirm, and he was like it's all there kinda rudely. I told him I was missing my biscuit. He looked at the screen and finally, almost reluctantly, gave me a biscuit. As he did I told him I wanted extra dipping sauce. He said it was 24 each almost like you won't pay for it. So I was like fine give me a ranch and a barbecue. He grabs the sauces and I get 50 from my center console. He still doesn't hand me the sauce till I hand him my payment. His arm is pulled back like him gonna reach and grab it from his hand. I hand him the 2 quarters and he hands me 2 sauces. He says have a good night as he turns his back to me. That thing drive-through workers do, so you can't ask them for ketchup and napkins and stuff. He was pretty damn adamant about getting payment, but turns his back on me. I loudly say hello, you owe me some change. He turned around and opened his drawer and hands me back a quarter and grumbles that he's waiting on change. During their divorce my stepfather was one day particularly more dickish to my mother, so while he was out, a plan was concocted. My SF was an avid milk drink, like 1-12 gallons of milk a week. The plan was simple, put that mustard water that forms when the mustard hasn't been used in a while. The reason why you usually shake the mustard before using it, ketchup has a similar effect, into the drinking milk. Since he drank so much milk, and since cooking often requires milk we had 2 jugs, a gallon for SF to drink, and a half gallon to cook with. Being very careful, my mother squirted the mustard water into his milk, then proceeds to shake it to make sure the mustard water is fully incorporated into the milk, but she ran into a problem, the milk became a tinge of yellow. Worried, the plan was still in motion, all she could do was place the milk back in the fridge and wait. And wait she did. That night, almost as if the gods of petty revenge guided him, my SF took a big glass of mustard water milk, not noticing the slight yellow tinge to it, and drank it. The following days my mother and I watched, me being in on the plan, as my SF took and drank more and more glasses of milk. None the wiser he never brought up the taste, but I had a glass myself to see if it was noticeable, and it was. One could definitely taste a slight mustard flavor to the milk, it was gross. However, the next week, my mom watered down the milk, something she did to elongate the use of the milk, seeing as my SF had started to drink out of the cooking milk too, and boy was he upset about the watered down milk, having an argument with my mother as soon as he tasted the milk, but mustard water milk was just fine. A bit of context: this was a job I worked last summer as the mad science guy at a summer camp. I really like the summer camp, so I won't mention any names of locations. I'm pretty young in my third year of college as an education major with a few other degree smoners, and accepted into a master's program. I would say I'm very overqualified for the position that I was in, and I worked in an organic chemical lab as an intern during the year. I was the mad science guy. I basically got to make my lesson plans and other things for the camp. During the week I would see anywhere from 400 to 600 kids during my activity. It was a big job for little pay, but I was proud of my work. I also had an unlimited budget for my activity, so I could do a lot of cool things with the kids. The kids all knew me throughout the camp, even the teens that I never worked with. I worked with preschool kids to 8th graders. Every group rated my activity as their favorite. My other co-workers were very qualified in their fields except for one stupid head. She was the nature lady and was older than rope. So we all had our lesson plans up on the same Google Drive. Some of us liked to team up on topics certain weeks so that it could be a really fun week for the kids. I could see everyone's lesson plans and everyone could see my lesson plans. So let's talk about Stupid Head. Stupid Head was supposedly a school teacher for 5th graders. I say supposedly because she was not prepared for anything. She had no lesson plans by the time camp started. She seemed nice at first, and she was alright for the first week. My opinion of her changed the second week. One of the counselors told me she was making slime. I asked one of the kids to show me their slime. It had glitter in it, which was from my lesson plan. She was stealing directly from my hard written and planned lesson plans. I take pride in my science and my precision. She added too much of one chemical, and it made the slime more liquidy. It made me furious. I confronted her right then and there. I basically told her to knock it off, and I told my superior. Nothing was done. I had made about 30 different experiments to choose from. She picked another one the next week. Now the revenge part. I had enough of her trying to do my job as the nature lady. So I changed every lesson plan and every experiment I had with inaccurate proportions. It would make things not react with each other or dirty up the kids a bit. Nothing dangerous, just would mess up their cloths. Every experiment was changed. I also would make her use bigger containers for things just to mess with her. She tried to do the experiments again, and they did not work. She was still working for the camp, so the next week I did something a little different. She tried doing elephant's toothpaste. When she wasn't looking, I replaced the hydrogen peroxide she had with water. It wouldn't go off. Later that week I was doing inventory and stuff was missing. I knew it was missing because I had not used it to that week. What she wanted was not what it actually was. I changed all the containers to have not accurate labels, so she wouldn't steal the stuff I was actually using that week. Unlucky for her, I rigged a trap that would make the container explode blue chalk all over the person that stole it. One morning I hear a scream at the camp. The container that was stolen exploded and covered her and kids in blue chalk. I literally caught her in the act of using my stuff. I told my boss, and she got into a lot of trouble. She didn't get fired, but it felt great to get back at her. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, a like and a comment would mean a lot in YouTube's world. Share with us if you would have done things differently, and don't forget to support the original authors with an upvote. Links are in the description. Peace out, and catch you tomorrow.